Welcome to this channel. The channel is for education and culture based on historical and scientific evidence. So today I'm going to reveal to you the 1850s Wing Chun Siu Lim Tao writing or the quilt. The Siu Lim Tao quilt of 1850 is the reference, standard reference of Wing Chun. So today I'm going to get to the details so you all know once for all on what is going on. Now, in the past a week or so, I have released this to YouTube. These two YouTubes. The reason I released these two YouTube is so that you can heard about my explanations or my demonstrations on what is going on. So, in order to understand the 1850 Siu Lim Tao quilt or writing, you need to know this. You need to know what is going on. It is very important so that you do not using today's Wing Chun mindset to think about the 1850 Siu Lim Tao writing. So the 1850 Siu Lim Tao writing, of course, that is the content of what you need to learn and develop when you practice Siu Lim Tao of Wing Chun. So I have summed up the basic here. Again, I am not here to promote myself or making any claim of grandmaster. I am here just to show you, like a high school teacher, this is the basic. And of course, I have to walk my talk here so that you can see exactly what's going on. Now, so today I'm going to get to the details of the 1850 Siu Lim Tao quilt so you know what is going on. Now, prior to that, I'd like to share something with you. You must understand that the Chinese in the ancient is very different than the Chinese mentality of today, or the Chinese culture according to the Westerner who study the sinology or get a PhD or something. You need to understand what is it. Then you'll be able to see the entire thing, or else it's like he says, she says, right? So, about 1,300 years ago, 1,300 years ago, the Chinese is at its Tang Dynasty. The Tang Dynasty. At that time, the China is like today's United States of America. At that time, the emperor and the empress can be female. Okay. And the Japanese who come to China to study can become the official of the Chinese government. And also, you can have the Buddhism come to China. You can have different religions all come to China. So it's like, you think about it, it's like today's United States of America. Everybody come into China and everybody bring a piece of their culture, their understanding, a lot of things. Now, at that time, the empress, yes, it is an empress. Nobody said that only man can be the boss. So it's the empress. So the empress, her name is Wu Zhitian. She is one of the supporter of Buddhism. So migrate the Buddha's teaching to China. Okay. At that time, she have this department supporting the government, supporting department to translate Buddhist Sutta, the Buddhist Sutta to Chinese. And it is like you have a hall of all the scholar and the monk there, and then translate it, and you have all the Chinese scholar will discuss, is this a proper translation? Is it according to the experience, according to the teaching of the Buddha? Now, so she support that. And she's the one who want to asking the sixth patriarch of Zen, Huinan, to go to the palace to presenting the Zen teaching. Now, at that time of the translations of Chinese Sutta, the emperors make like today a preface. And today's, if you recite the Chinese versions of the Buddhist Sutta, you still can read it. The last sentence is said, Yan jie ru lai zhen shi yi. I would like to understand the proper, the accurate meaning of the Buddha. Okay? So this is the empress. It's not, I am the big boss, listen to me. It's not. It's like, I want to understand, I want to know the proper, the accurate teaching of the Buddha. It is very, in today's term, it's very professional and really accurate. Now, at that time, the Chinese, especially in Zen, now we talk about Zen today, Buddha's teaching. The core of the Buddha's teaching is Yifa Bu Yiren in Mandarin. Yifa Bu Yiren, meaning that you follow what is the teaching, not the person. Another word, if my teacher teaching me physics, I follow the Newton's law. I'm not going to follow what my teacher's interpretations. Okay? So you need to remember, as the emperor said, I would like to understand exactly what is the teaching of Buddha. And then is the practice is following what is in that physics book, not follow what my teacher say. Okay, now. However, today, since past about 100 years, Did the Chinese do that? Nope. You look at today's Wing Chun. Oh, it's my grandmaster say this. My grandmaster say this. According to this guy, according to that guy, did anybody have the mentality of the real Chinese saying that I like to understand exactly what the Buddha is teaching? And I have to follow the books of physics, not what my teacher said. But today you look around, everybody is grandmaster. They promote their teacher as the grandmaster, making movies, all this thing, blah, blah, blah. Did anybody really care for one to understand what is the proper teaching of Wing Chun? Zero. Because everybody is promoting their lineage, their grandmaster, blah, 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 blah. Now, that type of behavior, which is not Chinese behavior, have screwed up Wing Chun big time. For example, when is that Bruce Lee support Wing Chun? Where in past 50 years, everybody promoting Bruce Lee's art is Wing Chun, blah, 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 blah. Like Bruce Lee is studying, based everything on Wing Chun. This is ChatGPT. This is what Bruce Lee said. Wing Chun is like a land swimming. Okay? Wing Chun did not endorse. Bruce Lee do not endorse Wing Chun. So, that is the reality. People is just using Bruce Lee's name to make money, to promote whatever they are teaching. This is from a book by a very reputed, very well-known Chinese martial art grandmaster in his own style. You say here clearly, you look at Bruce Lee, how many Wing Chuners are using Bruce Lee to make money, to make a living. This is the Chinese, the Chinese young people who actually is like the fan of Xi Xiaodong, who are Bruce Lee saying that Wing Chun is land swimming. So today's Wing Chun, do you base on the proper Dharma, like the physics book, or you just based on all this marketing stuff? And now it is blowing up in your face. Who can go delete everything in the ChatGPT? Who can go delete or ban this thing in the book, the Chinese martial art books by this grandmaster? Who can just ban this video, which presenting the fact that Bruce Lee is not endorsing Wing Chun? In contrary, it said it is a land swimming. Well, there's the reality. Now, in the same directions, the Canton Martial Art Association is creating a Wing Chun sets based on somebody who really don't know what is Wing Chun. So is this Chinese? It is not Chinese at all. As what I just tell you, even the emperor saying that I want to understand the proper, the accurate, the truth of what Buddha is teaching, and we follow like the law of physics of Sir Isaac Newton, not my teacher, not promoting my teacher, making movie and everything. So right now, Wing Chun collapsed in the history. We like it or not, you don't know what it is. This is really ugly in the history. And this is not Chinese. This is not Wing Chun. This is everybody up to create their own stuff just for making money or promoting whatever. And then they come to the West, the same thing, okay? It becomes chop suey. Or you add this, you add that, you add this, you add this. So this is the situation of Wing Chun today, 2023. If you guys in the later day, in the future, watch this video, this is exactly what happened on Wing Chun today. It's hopeless. Now, we cannot let this thing going on, keeping going on like this. So that's why I'm presenting this to you today. The writing of 1850 Xiu Lim Tao says. That is the reference. We need to follow the Dharma, the teaching, like the Newton's law. We need to understand what is going on, like the teaching of the Buddha. It's not my grandmaster say this, my lineage say this, and then at the end, you cannot face the world. So, good. Now you are in the ChatGPT. Can you erase that? You can. Okay. So now let's go into this, the writing of Wing Chun, because it is really serious, the Xiu Lim Tao writing. Okay. Now, in the entire history of China, in the entire history of China, the reality is there exists two writing of Wing Chun, two writing. So one writing is the 1850s anti-Qing Wing Chun writing of the Xiu Lim Tao sets. Okay, the essence of the details training. Xiu Lim Tao means the essence of detail training. In this set, there are four parts of it. Four parts of it. Four parts of it. It is not the 1850s or today's Wing Chun, Xiu Lim Tao leader idea set. It is not that. This is, even though it pronounced like Xiu Lin Tao, and today Xiu Lin Tao is like a really close, but it is a completely heaven and earth different. So this is the 1850 Xiu Lin Tao writing. Each of this writing is accord with the each momentum or move, or how do you use strength in that every move, okay? So every move or one or two move associate with one writing. We're gonna go into detail so you can see. So remember these four sets, four parts, this long sets, this sets, which is showing you the entire systems of Wing Chun. In the basic of it, okay, the basic of the Wing Chun. Now, this is the 1850s, 1870s Pro Qing Wing Chun leader ideas writing. So we know that 1850, this is anti Qing, the guy who really fight the Qing. This is after the Red Boat become pro-Qing. So this is created at 1870. Now, as I shared before, the creations of the Wing Chun 1870 is using a small fragment of the 1850s Wing Chun, adding Shaolin Wang Chun to make it. So today's the three sets is from this Pro Ching, and it has a small fractions of the 1850s Wing Chun. Now, if you compare it, the first part of the Wing Chun 1850 Xiu Lim Tao writing versus the 1870s Xiu Lim Tao leader the ideas writing, it is this. Okay, now over here I'm going to go to details. It have the six core element, the momentum, and all sort of stuff. Over here it doesn't have it. It just has something like white crane playing with the water, snake return to the hole, the snake nine turns, and then the snakes and crane are competing, and then the snake legs, and then sorry, the crane's leg, and then the white crane's fold is wing, and then the snake and crane can defeat this this trader. That's all. That's the writing of the Xiu Lim Tao 1870, where today's disregard of you are from Liangzhan lineage or from the Dai Fa Ming Gang lineage, everybody is using this. That's based on this. And this is the 1850s Xiu Lim Tao writing, the first part of it. So the 1870 is using a fragment of this to create this. So right now we want to get into here to let you see what is going on. Now, so in my book, Wing Chun Inception, the entire four part of the Wing Chun Quid 1850 has been translated to English. Yes, it is now in America. And so we want to go through this to let you see what is going on, what you need to achieve when you practice Xiu Lim Tao. It is not just like the white crane playing the water, snake return to the hole, and those, and then the rest is everybody is up for their everybody's creativity. Or my sifu say this, my grandmaster say this, this, this. No. This entire thing is not up for anybody's translations. It is Chinese culture, Chinese martial art culture. As before, I say that it has to be based on Qi Ji Guang, General Qi Ji Guang, based on Shaolin, based on Buddhism, based on Taoism's teaching. Now, if you have never watched these two videos yet, please watch it before you continue on, because you need to know what is going on here. Okay, it's like it is better that you have seen a car or an aeroplane. You've seen how the aeroplane, how it fly, how the aeroplane works. If you have never seen it, you need to see how it works before you start reading something and you start thinking. Or it's like, say, for example, if we live in the jungle, we never see this world before. Then we read about aeroplane. Then we say, what aeroplane? Oh, it used to be like a bird. You don't know about what is the Z, what is the entire thing. You just beyond your imaginations. So you need to go through this, and that's the reason why I share this with you. Okay. Now, so we need to know what I'm going to share with you today is we present whatever it is as it is. It's no my grandmaster, my lineage, I'm the king of Wing Chun, blah 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 blah. For past 100 years, all this thing is actually you end up screw everybody up and put everybody on the Titanic. And then, of course, in past 100 years, everybody like can translate this the Shulim Tao writing, the white crane playing with the water and snake return to hole as whatever they you want to translate it. And yet, if you see this, there is no room for those things. Otherwise, you cannot develop the Kung Fu. So, within this book, the translations, if you read that writing of 1850, the first thing you say is, this is an advanced method. It wonderfully developed the body, mind, and energy. Okay? So you know what it is. And the second, he said that if you don't understand without a clear understanding on the concept of attack and defense, it is a mistake. If you watch this, this video, I show you already. The concept of attack and defense is what? Concess without concede without concessions. And keep or stay in dynamic balance with dynamic imbalance. All those stuff. Okay? So first, you need to understand this. You need to know this. These two momentum elements. Otherwise, you really don't know what you're talking about. Okay? And so that is the first two writing of the entire Shulim Tao. Now, after that, you say practice instructions. Your eyes must track your hand. Your hand must track your mind or your heart. Hand issue from heart or mind. The details of mind and body synchronization has to be meticulous. Now, 1870, they took bit and piece, fragmented thing from the 1850 to create today's Shulim Tao. So today, you hear in all the Wing Chun entire world about fist issue from heart, hand issue from heart, but you do not see this. You don't know that it has the eyes must track the hand, hand must track with the heart, and then hand issue from heart. This is the closing the loop. So if you don't have this, you just have this, well, you interpret whatever you want. And that's why it creates a mess. You don't know what it is. Now, and it continue on. Okay, so this is the practice instruction. It continues on. It says that what? Every stretch and every contract. Well, that is over here again. It says about the contract and expanding, the contractions and extension, where you have to handle your body so that you can shoot out. So it tells you already. Okay, your body, your footwork has to align, has to generate that momentum. So please watch that, the other video. And then he said, within soft, there is hardness. Within hardness, there is softness. When you play, you don't want to go extreme. So this is meaning that you always be able to recycle stuff. You don't go extreme to this, just go completely like a piece of wood or completely like a rope, okay? And then over here it says slow movement is analog logos to calm, smooth wave. Fast movement is analogous to violent wave. So this entire thing, it is your using of recycling momentum to exert your strength and your move. So over here, it tells you already. Okay, your how you handle your body, your footwork, and how you handle your recycling momentum. So no, sorry, Wing Chun is not just hand must track. Hand issue from heart. Wing Chun is not just hand issue from heart. Like today, everybody in the entire world, you say the hand issue from heart. No, it's not that. There's more thing to that. Okay. So you see, before you practice the Shu Lin Tao, you need to know all this thing. That's why I make this to show you. If you don't know this, how the world you know what it is? You might want to practice your Wing Chun with the BJJ way or Western Boxing way or Hong Ga way or Tai Chi way. Well, sorry, it is not. That's why I show you this. It is well defined here. Of course, the problem is the approaching people, they don't get this piece of information. That's why their riding is white crane playing with the water, snake return to the hole, the snake turn 9 times, all those kind of stuff, very superficial stuff, up for your creativity. Over here, there's no up for creativity. Okay? And like this, every stretch and every contract, if you don't have the Shaolin Short Strike Classic to decode it, you don't know what it is. So you need to have the Shaolin Short Strike Classic to decode this thing. Okay? Then you know, oh, this is the entire thing is playing with momentum. And of course, the Shaolin Classic is based on General Qi Ji Guang. Okay, so let's go for the first part. Okay, this is part two here. The first part, which is really resembling today's Shu Lin Tao set or leader idea set, but it is not. So let's get into it and see what happened. Now, you better first watch this video on this internal different state of the body conditioning. So you can make sense of what is going on in this writing in the first part of the Shu Lin Tao. So here, like the first one, it says that quiet the mind, return to awareness, standing in the equal shoulder stance. Okay? Two hands raised up in front, aware of the yin and the yang. The trip out of leg have positive and negative effect. The bending power of the right heel tightly stored in the reverse directions. Union in the Dan Tian, Du Meridian, Sing. So this is the entire thing on the six core element. You just stand there, you have to aware of your six core element and how each of them operate. And also here, when he said the union in Dan Tian, Du Meridian, Meridian descends, You know that if you watch this YouTube, you watch this YouTube, this one, it is get into the breathing. It's get into the breathing. You need to have the lower, natural lower abs breathing, as I have presented in that YouTube. Okay, so it's like in the YouTube, I share how you're standing there to develop your body with your, what do you call it, your dynamic stretching and your breathing. You need to have that. Okay, then only if you have that, you'll be able to attain or achieve whatever you practice in the Shaolin Tao set according to the instruction. Now, you continue on saying that the arm wipe out the horizontal force. Okay, so that is playing with the force flow, and of course, your body has to condition according to what I share with you on other video. And then it even say pay attention to your finger crawl under your sleeves. Okay, the side under your sleeves over here. All airy joints and everything, this is a lot of details there. And then it say spiral twisting naturally following the breathing and directions of the chi. You know, this is like in the previous YouTube, you got to get into the state of be able to handle your energy flow. Okay, so let's get it. So as you see that rotate palm railing guarding the heart, it all is really detailed, describe what you need to do, what you need to develop. And over here it says single horizontal and double press according to your breathing. Now your breathing has to synchronize your with your body, your body motion exertions of your strength, like in the previous video. Okay. Now, over here is embracing and sinking, split the force horizontally, embracing and sinking. Remember in other video, I say that you need to have the dynamic stretching where your hip and your shoulder, the entire body link up. So when you're sinking, embracing, sinking, and you split, your entire body go. It's not like today you stand in the structure and then you're just moving your arm and not moving your elbow because it's called immobile elbow. Okay. Well, somebody created those things, but that is not in the 1850s, the Shaolin Tao. So again, you see that you said following natural. Spontaneously with the chi will flow in a peaceful and balanced way. It always is trying to balance things with the chi. It is a dynamic handling. Okay. And over here he said moving the arm upward and downward, similar to flying flower in the wind. Now, like the flower flying in the wind, force and chi flow are flown. Meaning that your strength and your chi flow, your strength and your chi flow. Of course, chi flow, you have to have your breathing intact. So when you inhale and you exhale, how you exert your strength, how you move your body. That is disclosed there in this thing. And then he said that swallow and speeding like a smooth rainbow issue force. Okay. So where is this from? Well, the talk how? Swallow, swallow. You see my body go? Swallow and speeding. When I swallow, my body go in already. Okay, so talk sound is not like this, whatever you call it, you know. It's not like somebody's hand is hitting me and then I just try to scoop it or move it away. No, it is using this as a stepping stone so that I move in. That's called swallow. Once I'm close, this is splitting him. So it is not like today everybody interpret swallow, spit, float, sing. It's not. It's the entire thing. It is in dynamic and it is one piece. Okay? One, it is one. Entire thing is one piece and it is in dynamics, the three-dimensional dynamic moving. Now, at the end, he said, follow the natural, spontaneously, the breathing and chi will be nurtured. Meaning that at the end of first section, you have to go back and you need to go back to the recovery or the nurture chi states. So there are, if you look at it this way, at the beginning, it is in the nurture chi type of state, the nurture chi conditioning or the recovery. And then it slowly work up to the high level of fitness, high intensity fitness. And then when you get into here, it is exerting force, exerting strength. You know, there's a strengthening training, the third part of the training, the conditioning already. So you have the recovery fitness and the strengthening or the martial art training, the third, right? Three. So at the beginning, you are in that recovery and you work out, because this is a martial arts. You work up to the strengthening to deliver your strength and so forth, playing with your force flow and everything. And then at the end, you go back to the recovery. So it is like you boost the intensity, you raise the intensity up. You raise the intensity up while you're practicing Shu Lin Tao, and then you ramp it down. First section. It is not like today, where everything is slow like that. It's not like that. Now, you have to be paid, you have to be careful. For example, over here, you say, lower knob at the Guan Yuan area, then turn into Buddha consort hand. So, or Buddha praying hand. Okay? So, this is the Guan Yuan area. So, what did it say? So, what it say is like, this is not at the Guan Yuan area. Turn into the Buddha praying hand. And you inhale. This is the Buddha praying hand. It's not this. It's not this. This is the Buddha praying hand. Okay? So if you practice that first part of the 1850 Shu Lin Tao, you have to go through all those stuff. You have to go through all those stuff. You have to go through all this internal conditioning stuff. You need to know all the states here. And of course, when you're just beginning to practice Shu Lin Tao, you will not be able to handle everything like this. So you need to go through one condition by one, or recovery, fitness, and then the strengthening, and the Sifu always have to go gut watch you. Do you really get it in the recovery? Do you get it in the fitness? Do you get it in the strengthening? Or is your body is okay to practice the martial or the strengthening? If not okay, then you must not touch it. There's the job of the Sifu. And then at the end, you'll be able to perform like this part one according to this. And that's how you strengthen your body, how you condition your body with the Shu Lin Tao sets. And you have all those techniques here, right? So like I have shared with you just now, okay? Like this rotating palm, real guarding the heart. And then like this, embracing and sinking, split the force horizontally, and this swallowing and speeding, like the smooth rainbow issuing force. So swallowing and speeding, okay? So everything is here. It is not your today's Shu Lin Tao or leader idea set. We know since 1870, because we now have hold of this thing. We now have the hold on this thing. We know even in 1870, they do not see the full picture already. They do not have the details. They don't have the six core element. They don't have all this momentum, all this thing, as what I just shared with you. So, sorry, it is not Shaolin Wang Chun. Sorry, it is not White Crane Wing Chun from Fujian. Sorry, it is not Tai Chi. Sorry, it's not this internal, that internal. The reality is like this. The writing is a writing. Okay? And as I say again and again, in order to crack the code or to understand this writing, you need to read the previous writing, like the Hermes Shi Zhuang writing, the Shaolin Sword Strike writing, the Qi Ji Guang writing, or else you have no idea what it is. So you look around today, the entire world's Wing Chun. What is it? You know right away, all this is creating. My lineage says so. I create this. But people say, well, it's Mang, Shaolin, what? Ji Sim, or this Ngmui. Are you serious? So that is the creed. That is the standard that we need to get there, at least in the minimum. We be able to do whatever in that writing in order to say that I know the Shu Lin Tao sets. I have studied, I know what it is. Only with that you can teach other. So that two video I share with you, that is really basic. And if you don't have this basic, you cannot practice your Shu Lin Tao. And if you do not develop with your Shu Lin Tao, you don't have that basic. So now you can see Wing Chun is not land swimming per Bruce Lee. Because Bruce Lee never seen this. Bruce Lee don't know this. And also other grandmaster from other martial art, disregard who they are. They don't know what is Wing Chun.